Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Welcome to our Saturday stream, where we just, you know, play some games, see what gets our attention, see what seems kind of fun. And you can talk about, you could just talk about the chat situation you have going on there. If anyone wants to know the password to the chat, you can just give that out. That's fine. That's just there to try to prevent some random IRC spamming stuff like last, well, 2 weeks ago. So, what do we got for this week? Well, you know, something I felt we might want to play is Dead.Kings. Dead.Kings, I should say, because a number of people were telling me that this was actually a pretty good game. I didn't really get anywhere at all in the demo video, but there were people saying that I should give this another shot, that the game had updated, and there was a bunch of new stuff in it. And yeah, there was an update when I looked at it again. So, let's start. Let's start our dark and creepy adventure. Is this a ripoff of King something? You mean King's Field? Well, it has some stuff in it that maybe King's Field did not have. We'll take a look at that. I could hold L and R to map my inventory items if I wanted. Here we are. Like, remember from the demo, we don't want the candle to go out. It's like Shadowgate. Our candle going out would be real bad. Just a few items to help us on our way as we get started. And if I run too fast, it looks like that the flame might go out. Alright, so here's this castle, which, I mean, looking at it from the outside, it really doesn't seem all that big. But inside the castle are supposed to be all kinds of treasures. I'm gonna light that up. Could save the game right here, but we just started. Alright. Yeah, don't pull the lever. I do remember last time pulling the lever ended up me getting arrowed. Yeah, I remember what happened in there. That's the treasure chest with all the bones that caused my light to go out. So I'm not gonna go down there. Rather, I'm gonna go here, where there was that skeleton. Oh, did I buy it? Yes, this is the full version of the game. This is no longer the demo. Now, we saw this guy in the demo, but something is a little different. I can talk to him now. Couldn't do that in the old version. It's Creaky! He's one of the Dead.Kings. We could follow him, we could trade items, or go explore. Just go explore. Why not? Where's he going? I'm sure he's off to have adventures. I mean, we could probably just walk away and do something else. I'm kind of curious to know where he's going. What? Is that all, Creaky? Is that... Just follow me, Creaky. Come on. You didn't even go anywhere. Yes, he is King Creaky. Truly a majestic name. So he's gonna follow us around. Look, I'm not pulling that this time. You better not either, Creaky. I'm not sure if you could. You are a ghost, but I don't know if you can pull that. Yeah. You can fall down there. There is an area down there. I think I can survive it if I have full health. Survive the fall, but, let's stay up here for right now, I think. Arrows, but fortunately, we have a lever right here. See, I guess I'm learning that I can use that to turn the arrow traps on and off. Creaky? What was that, Creaky? Do you know what that was? Oh, he actually can give us hints. He can tell us that we're standing near a lever. He doesn't know what that rumbling was just about right now, though. Yeah, Creaky's helpful. I'm sure that won't be bad at all. Those escaping ghosts from the cursed treasure. That's no problem. Looks like that the stream went down for a second, but they're back now. Huh? Arrows. I'm gonna have to... This game is fond of its arrow traps. Alright, now here's something we didn't get to in the demo. We could find these portraits around the castle, and we can activate them. This one looks very messy. Now, why would it be messy? Well, this is a portrait of Duke Francois, drowned in a pool of vomit in March of 468 AD. A very... very not distinguished death, really. But this is Duke Francois. He wants to challenge us! We can either jump, shoot, or block. Okay, Duke Francois. What if I wanted to jump? What's that about? Getting hints from the Frenchman. Okay. It's checkers. We're playing checkers against the dead Duke Francois who drowned in his own vomit. Now it is the time to set our traps. I'm going to set some nail traps around here. I don't think my pieces can set off my own traps, so I think I'm all right. All right, I'll just set some nail traps over there, and let's start the game. All right, I'm going to play against Francois in checkers. Now the row in front of my pieces are trapped with nails. We'll just find out what... Can I change the camera view? There we go. Okay, that's a bit better. All right, I'm going to move a piece. Let's see how this goes. What does Francois want to do about that? Okay... I don't know why they want to play, why Francois wants to play against me in checkers. I mean, or why he wants to challenge me at all. Sure, he must have his reasons. Oh, nailed! There you go! See, I got money because of that. Alright, so he could take one of my pieces, so I have no choice. I have to use that piece to take this. Am I seeking a way out? Oh, I got trapped! No, the hammer! Did I lose money? Maybe, but I'm getting it right back with these nails. Arrowed! Francois is not shy about using his traps. Alright, I'm gonna have to go this way. This is the bloodiest game of checkers ever. Well, I guess I have to do this. Oh, double jump! Francois is laughing at me! And the traps, I think, can be used over and over. So, if a space is a trap, it's trapped. It is trapped for the entire game. Alright. My only chance here, I think, is to get that piece up to get a get kinged, but, it's not happening right now, at least. What? Oh, no! Did I take too much time? How good would I say I'm at checkers? I would say I've not played checkers, probably in, like, over a decade or two. I would say that, until now. Alright, so he's taken a lot of my pieces, but his back row is exposed and mine is not yet, so I think I'm doing okay. I think I have a clear path. You wouldn't think this is what you would be doing in Dead.Kings. It seemed like, you know, atmospheric and menacing. And then we find out, hey... checkers. You know, the undead portraits, they enjoy a good game of checkers, too. I could move that out of the way, but I'm going to keep it here to force him to take that piece while I get kinged. Congratulations! I got kinged, and now I'm getting hit with a hammer. I think I'm doing all right. start attacking from behind. Yeah, he knows what I'm doing. Francois knows I'm coming for him. You can hammer me all you want, Francois. But I think your number's up. That's right. And I'm getting additional money. Still don't know why I'm getting hit with those arrows. If that's time-based or what. Francois's on the run. Is this the new Devil May Cry game you've heard about? Yeah, this is the bold new direction of Devil May Cry. Alright, guess I'm just gonna get a second king. Or I could just move this one down to intercept the red checker. Oh, I guess that's it. That's right, Francois. You were foolish to challenge me! Oh, all these coins! All of them! I got all the coins. I got dusty coins. I could probably shine those off. It'd be worth more. I have to press Y to gather them up for some reason. I have to do this manually. I could hide this. I could also dump. I don't know why I would do this. I'm just gonna pick it right back up again. Okay, I beat Francois. Now, why would I want to do that, aside from the money and the satisfaction? Oh, look, I cleaned up his portrait while I was doing that. I have a little medal right there. So, hey, at least Francois' portrait is not covered with vomit anymore. And the gate, there was a gate that's now gone. Oh, there it is. Yeah, that was down before, so I had to defeat him to make that go up and advance on. Yeah, why not? I'll buy Spike Trap. So the NPCs in this game all seem to be, portraits. Alright, I gotta find the Queen's Tiara to use that portrait. Cassio, your GF is saying this is not historically accurate. I would like to see proof that this is not how history went. Rufus the Butler died of gout in 404 AD. Let's try shooting. Okay, Rufus the Butler, in June 404 AD, what did it mean to shoot? It means asteroids. Now, I don't know about you. I cannot remember a From Software game that had asteroids in it. So clearly, this is the superior game. It has so much more to it. Like, we all know in the 400s how popular the game of asteroids was. Even the smallest hamlet did have ye olde arcade with at least asteroids. Oh! It's at the edge of the screen and got hit by a spawning asteroid. What platform is this on? This is an Xbox Live indie game. So it's available on the Xbox 360. And it might be the only platform it is on. I don't know if this was actually on PC or anything else. On the Ouya? Don't believe I've seen it on the Ouya. Pretty sure I have not seen it on here. On there. Did I like asteroids as a child? Well, I don't recall actually seeing it in the arcades. By the time I was in arcades, I guess, asteroids was considered old hat. Was considered old and busted. Oh, the UFO! Ye old UFO! Why are the Dead Kings in space? You know, you think you can escape from the Dead Kings if you want to go into space? No, you cannot. The dead kings are everywhere. Alright, so I started over again. Oh, I leveled up! Let's go back to the castle. What was my favorite arcade game? Oh, hold on. His picture's all cleaned up. We got a medal. So I don't know how far we had to go in Asteroids to pass that, but it seems that whatever we just did, we were able to win and, get by. Impressed with that, Creaky? You ever play Asteroids, Creaky? What do you think about that? I can push him to rage quit? Well, I think we should probably move on and see what else this castle has. Sure, I'll buy a trap. Creaky has nothing to say about what those rumbles are. I should be more careful with my gold. Yeah, I am spending it a lot. Now we've got a second floor. Yeah, we might as well save. Oh. It's all fancy and purple up here. Creaky? Okay, so we're where the nobles live, and this is a big painting. But I need the bone key. What? What's going on? Oh no, Batman! Batman, don't steal my... No, Batman, stop stealing my money! Can you believe that, Creaky? The nerve! Ah. I don't think I'm gonna be able to get past that. I need to find the queen. Okay, I think this is gonna be a dead end. These devs could get sued so hard. You know, as far as some of the other copyright infringement we've seen in Xbox Live indie games, it doesn't seem to be like something that they worry about. It seems pretty freewheeling on the X-Blig. I don't think we went down this way. Oh, yeah, another stained portrait. Okay, Chef Buttbeef, you know, that name, I think, does not sound entirely historically accurate. Maybe it's a nickname. He was chopped up with a meat cleaver in 399 AD. We can defeat him and expand the castle. Okay, so the third challenge, we haven't done it yet, is block. So what's that? It is breakout. Chef Buttbeef is challenging us to breakout. I already lost one ball already because of how low that thing is. Let me get it around the edge. Get it around? No! Around? Ah. Oh, this one's kind of tough. Get it around these invincible... These invincible... Yeah, this is not working out so well. Trying to get it around these invincible blocks. Can it? No, not quite. So breakout, of course, very popular in the olden days. You know, the olden days. The days of old. God, come on, just get it in there. Just a little more. I don't think it's going in there, you guys. I don't think it's happening. How do the controls feel? They're kind of sensitive. But I'm not having much trouble... or anything. I mean, aside from the trouble of getting that ball just up into that little thing. Okay. I'm gonna have to leave that. Let me go back into it and let me see if it's gonna be the same configuration. Yep, it is. I'm not gonna be able to get in there. Alright, Chef Buttbeef. You're pretty good at breakout. What about chess? Checkers, I should say. I don't think there's chess in here. So, we're pretty good at checkers, Buttbeef. and see how good you are. I'm gonna set my traps. Alright, let's do this thing. Come on, Buttbeef. Got your number, Buttbeef. Yeah, it seems like I think all the traps do is get me money, which is fine. I do enjoy that they have the name Chef Buttbeef in the upper right the whole time. Man, such carnage happening in this game of checkers. Alright, I guess he knew if he moved that one out of the way, I would have been able to double jump. Eh, Buttbeef, you are shrewd. I'll give you that. Alright, looks like I'm getting a king already, so doing okay. Alright, now the carnage begins. Guess I'll leave that there, and let's see. This game of cat and mouse between knight and chef, one alive and one dead. Of the game of checkers, for some reason, I still don't know why. I'm sure it'll all make sense in the end. Like most games I play, makes sense in the end, Jack Slate. It is true. I do have a tendency of playing games that have very methodically written, well-explained stories. Just a knack, I guess. Just make sure I don't leave the bottom row. Yeah, that kind of seems like what I'm thinking about. With two kings... Oh, the plays! The huge plays that are happening here. My king got caught, but I got fireworks to go off because of my sweet plays. But that's all right, I guess, because I still do have one king, and he can't do anything about that unless he captures it. Oh wait, I actually do have to do this now, since it's not letting me pick anything else. I have to do that. Alright, that was a good move, actually, because I can't capture that now. Oh wait, why did I do that? I should not have done that. But at least it lets me capture that. Let's pull him up to my king, and we'll see who can get into the best position. Alright, he's scared of my king. He knows what I'm trying to do. In the meantime, I guess I can move this guy up to get another king, and then hopefully with two kings, I will be able to maneuver the enemy king. Yeah, you're just AI is just moving that king back and forth, because Buttbeef is lost. Buttbeef does not know what to do now. Buttbeef is desperate. The desperation of Chef Buttbeef. Buttbeef's completely lost. He does not know what to do here. I guess I should. Yeah, Buttbeef will never accept defeat. Maybe I can make Buttbeef rage quit. Oh, fire trap! I haven't seen one of those yet. Looks like he's gonna get a second king. But what are you gonna do with that king, Buttbeef? You have any plans on what you're gonna do with that king? What strategy does Buttbeef have? I have a feeling the strategy is going to involve just moving back and forth like this. That's probably what the strategy is gonna be. Mm-hmm. We're kind of at an impasse here. Like, we're just gonna move back and forth, I guess. Okay. Try kinging the lower left piece. Yeah, I'll do that if I can get, if I can get his king away from it. It looks like I am starting to move his king away from that piece. Some kind of truce to Buttbeef? What kind of truce would Buttbeef accept, though? He is quite proud, we can see. Yes, invigorating gameplay. I got him surrounded by three pieces, but, I mean, Buttbeef just is not letting me take that piece. Oh, wait, that's actually a good move by Buttbeef, because he could take one of those two kings, so I guess let's move this guy out. Alright, Buttbeef, I still have a chance to get a second king. Man, the tension of this game versus Buttbeef! You can cut it with a buzzsaw! Alright, Buttbeef. What now? The bards will tell tales of this conflict, of this game of wits between these two people. So, we both have two kings, and we're both just moving back and forth on this board, and neither of us could really do anything. Oh, you can rage quit the game, but can I make Buttbeef rage quit? Is the question. I can't approach Buttbeef, or else he will take one of my kings. Remember when I thought this was trying to be a Dark Souls ripoff? Yeah. Yes, I do remember that. So maybe Buttbeef died when he was killed by an angry competitor in checkers. I could see that's how he would probably have gone. All we can really do is go back and forth. There are no other moves to make. I'm just sweating from this tension. So I can't move with that king. Still can make moves with this one. And now I can move right back with this one. Why even bother to put in the other minigames? This is what Dead.Kings is all about. Yeah, I agree. This is clearly just a wrapper for a checkers game. Why do the enemies get traps if you don't lose money to them and they don't do anything? I don't know. Yeah, that's confusing. I still know where those arrows are coming from. What was that? Some animation of the other crown turning? Okay, it looks like, yeah, we're in a stalemate here where we're just gonna keep doing this over and over. And I don't know if they're... Well, hold on. I don't think there's any options about doing anything else or trying to make Buttbeef rage quit. I don't think there's anything we can do here. All right, I guess we are indeed going to have to rage quit the game. I don't really want to rage quit, but, I mean, Buttbeef... Wait... Tolling Bells, do you have a way of conquering Buttbeef? Do you have a method to defeat the Buttbeef? I don't know what that is. Turning the crown like that. I didn't know I could zoom in like this. Oh man, look at this dramatic camera angle. This is great. Now we're really getting in the head of the crown. Oh yeah, it does clean it off. We're really getting in our heads here, wondering who is going to conquer. Yeah, nothing under that table. The game of butts, yes. So, I don't think there's anything we can do, unfortunately. We're just gonna keep doing that over and over. flip the table. You know, if there was a way to flip the table, I would do it, but I don't think there is. Yeah, I really don't think there's any moves we can make at this point. Yeah, I think we're just gonna have to do this. I'm sorry, everyone, but we have to rage quit the game. I just threw it away, threw that board away. Will we ever be able to live down this defeat to Chef Buttbeef? I don't know. I just don't know. Such a contest! He is still covered in vomit. Creaky, you gotta know something about what that is. Well, something just came through here and took my candle out. And that's bad because, let's see. Oh, that's right, I have things. Okay, I can use this. Not really working, so... Oh, there we go. Okay, yeah, I have some objects, some items, whoops, that we can take a look at. I have been picking these things up as we've been going. So maybe that shaking is the thing that came through here. Alright, Buttbeef, I have to defeat you to go on, so I'm gonna take you on in asteroids. That has to be how this goes. Buttbeef. Seriously, Buttbeef, please. Buttbeef, your haughty portrait is keeping us from advancing in the castle. So many asteroids. Is Buttbeef controlling the asteroids? I don't think anyone controls the asteroids. No one can control such a force of nature. I hear the UFO. There it is. Oh, maybe Buttbeef was controlling the UFO, though. Look at the description of the glasses. Sure, I can do that. You know, it is a pretty good recreation of asteroids. Ah. Can't get past round six! And I'm pretty sure the way this probably works is I have to get past the level it puts me on. So, like, oh, do I have bombs? Ah, there we go, yeah, I do have bombs. I also have shield. That did not look like those shields protected me. Just want to say. But I'll put it up again. Oh, there we go. Okay, round seven. Now, I think probably since I got past that round, it means I have beaten Buttbeef. Whoops, no, I don't want to do that. Let's find out. Oh, I can let Creaky explore to find more gold. Oh, there we go. Buttbeef is all cleaned up. We could challenge him again in checkers if we wanted to. Defeat the king and get his crown to teleport. We don't have that. Now, someone said to look at the description for the glasses. Let's see. This is how other players see you online. Opponents can see where you are, what you are looking at, and watch you float around the checkerboard. Okay, so there is online play to Dead.Kings. Good thing there aren't any other players. I don't know how we would know that. I need the jade key. Let's have Creaky go explore. Maybe he can find something. And while he's doing that, let's go off in this other direction and see if there's anything here to find under the jade door. So far it's been a lot of hallways. What? Sure is. I don't know what that was about. Yep, why not? I don't know if I should pull that. Nope! That trap is still going. Well, I assume I have to pull the switch at some point. I have to pull levers. It's that sound again. So this is called Dead.Kings, but we've only seen one king so far. What? Oh no, it's here. Hold on, let me see if I have anything I can heal myself with. I do have a health vial. Alright, feeling better. So it looks like whatever that was almost killed us. It's still here, I think. And I don't... Drink! Drink! Drinking! Why is my health going down so much? Alright, it stopped going down. Still don't know a lot of how Dead.Kings works. It's very mysterious. I mean, you can see that. Oh no! Am I out of, Yeah, I think I might be out of... out of flint. Can't relight this. So wait, was there a torch? Yeah, there was one back here. And that's why we want to make sure that we light the torches as we find them. Let's find out what's down here. Well, I'm almost... okay, something's hurting me anyway, so... Alright, now I have full health. Let's try this. Well, my candle went out. What's this? Oh, I got white pearls. Yes, we are indeed in the Bone Zone. We can see that many adventurers had met their ends here. Is there a way out from here? It might not be. Is that a dog I'm hearing? Maybe I should climb up to that higher one up there. Oh, look. There is a dagger? Oh, yeah. We have the royal dagger. Let's see if we can equip that and what it does. Oh, there it is. Valuable weapon is very sharp, was once used by the queen. Oh, no, I can't use it yet. So it looks like this is not... I don't know if we have any kind of combat going on, aside from, of course, checkers. So that might just be an item to be used in a puzzle somewhere. I have not seen anything else in this area. But, I mean, you can go down here. You can find the pearl, and you can find the dagger. So, there must be a way out of this once you've gone down. I mean, maybe we don't have that. Maybe we have to find a way to teleport ourselves out. Something like that. Maybe I should rekindle my candle. Unfortunately, look at those suspended bones. Unfortunately, I cannot rekindle the candle because we are out of flint and there's no torches or anything around here. So yeah, it does appear that it is a sad thing that my adventures have ended here. Maybe we'll pick up again with Dead.Kings at some point, but I think that this is an area from which we cannot advance from. It's bloody. There's blood on this rock. No, don't. This was terrible. Well, I mean, I am kind of curious as to where this goes. I mean, what the objective is and who the other kings are. I'm kind of curious about it, but, it seems that this is... flying bones! Where are those coming from? But it does seem like that this is... It's possible you can come here, but maybe you need something else to teleport yourself out of here or something, because I do not see a way to walk out. But there are constant bones falling from the sky into the bone zone. I think that's going to be good enough for Dead.Kings right now. Let's see... So, like I said, maybe I'll work out on what it is we need to do at some other time and get back to that. Maybe with a bit more direction, we'll be able to find out, you know, where we need to go in the castle and if there's anything else to it, but, you know, checkers and asteroids and breakout. We didn't really even get to breakout. I mean, that was just not, I did not see a way of beating that breakout. I think that probably what we'll do, last time you might remember, is that we were playing Star Control 2, and we were rudely interrupted by a constantly crashing stream, so maybe we should get back to that. Did I clean the disc? This disc should be pretty clean. Now, something that was mentioned last time is we were not entirely sure as to who owned Star Control 2, and as such, who does EA owe royalties to for Mass Effect? That obviously completely ripped this off. According to one commenter, Kitsune Zeta, he says, yeah, this is a complex one. Accolade was the original publisher, and they got purchased by Atari SA, known at the time as Infogrames. Atari went bankrupt, and now Stardock owns the rights to the game's name, Star Control, and other stuff. The copyright of the Star Control universe and source code for Star Control 2 on PC was explicitly excluded from the sale of Toys for Bob to Activision, Toys for Bob being the developer. So it is still owned by Paul Reich III and Fred Ford, who released the source code that permitted the creation of source ports like the Urquan Masters. Some other elements specific to the 3DO version are owned by Crystal Dynamics, so yeah, complicated. So according to Kitsune Zeta, if Kitsune Zeta is correct, it looks like Stardock owns the name Star Control. They don't own the game. Activision bought the developer, but Star Control was not part of the sale. The original developers still own Star Control 2, the game, not the name, so they re-released it on the PC as the Urquan Masters, but some parts of the 3DO version that we're playing are still owned by Crystal Dynamics, so I guess that includes things like the FMV intro that is not in the Urquan Masters. So that's all of that explained. I'm still not sure who EA owes money to. But let's get started. Let's load the game. We were still in the Sol system. Let's see. We were on Mars. Yeah, some people were insisting that we need to go to Pluto. So, okay, let's head to Pluto. Still can't see where it is. This far out. Still can't see where it is on the outermost ring. I can see the ring, but I don't see Pluto. Oh, hold on. Okay, so there's only a couple things on here, that being a purple thing, and we saw a white point, which is an energy scan. Let's pick up the purple thing first. It's, 10 Zoe crystals, so maybe we'll use that some way. All right, let's take a look at this energy signal, see what we got here. Oh no! Kowalski, Fritz, Chin, and O'Donnell, and Luigi, and the Lieberman triplets, they're all dead! We knew them so well. They're irreplaceable. Alright, it looks like we got a hostile on the surface of Pluto.
Attention, big, mean, hostile alien vessel hovering overhead in an obvious attack posture. This is Spotty Captain Thwistle. I know you are going to torture me, so let's just get this over with right now. The coordinates of my homeworld, Spotiwa, are 241.6 by 368.7, and the ultra-secret Spotty cipher, which is known only by me and several billion other Spotty, is Happy Muffy Duffy. Sorry about that little mistake with your landing vehicle. I was so startled when it approached my vessel in a threatening manner that my automated defense systems fired on it when it got too close. I hope nobody got hurt.
Well, a few people did get hurt, unfortunately, by the automated defense systems. But, I mean, Captain Fwifo does seem to say that he's peaceful. And he has upbeat music. Well, let's see. Well, I mean, I think he already did identify himself. We come in peace. I'm not sure about not meaning him any harm, though. He did kill a number of people. I don't want to say don't kill us, because, you know, we obviously have the upper hand here. And, I mean, I think that we need to open up communications with Fwifo. Let's just take a stern stance to begin with.
Of course. As I said, I am Captain Fwifo of the Spotty Lordship Star Runner. Our sensors have tracked your entry into the system, which you are no doubt here to conquer. And while you are certainly welcome to do so, we would be greatly appreciative if you would please just go away and forget this star system ever existed. If you don't go, it will greatly complicate our master-slave relationship with the Urquan, who stationed us here to watch over the Earthlings.
Okay, so the Urquan stationed Fwifo here to monitor Earth. So I guess Fwifo here is one of the hierarchy of battle thralls. So let's see. Well, I mean, we don't... I think that we need to practice some understanding. I mean, we want to defend ourselves if it's necessary, but I don't think we want to take the offensive if we don't need to.
Phew, thanks. For a minute there, I thought you were going to kill me.
So let's see, what's he doing here? Where are the Urquan right now?
Our masters don't really keep us very well informed about their goings-on, so that all we know is that immediately after the subjugation of the last Alliance race, the Yehat, I think, the Urquan gathered their dreadnoughts and departed toward the edge of the galaxy, commanding us to obey the slave laws or face their wrath when they returned.
Alright, the Urquan are out at the edge of the galaxy doing what they're doing. I guess the Sol system is not all that important to them.
About 20 years ago, this region of space was dominated by a loose confederation known as the Alliance of Free Stars, which was composed of the aliens native to these parts who did not want to be enslaved. They made a valiant effort against the superior Urquan forces. It even looked like they might miraculously defeat the combined Urquan armada, right up to the point at which the Urquan totally defeated, indeed annihilated them.
Alright, so the Alliance of Free Stars tried to fight against the Urquan, but were utterly defeated. And I guess he didn't answer our question about what is he doing here on Pluto.
When the Urquan Armada entered the system to subjugate formerly the Earthlings, the Urquan presented the humans with the standard slave options. Join the hierarchy as combat thralls and retain some autonomy, including the right to travel through space, or become a fellow species, and return to free atomic savagery on the surface of their homeworld, encased for all time beneath an impenetrable force shield. The humans chose the latter option, and so were swiftly imprisoned on the surface of Earth. But the Urquan didn't trust them to obey the restrictions, so they chose a small group of hierarchy combat starships from the in-life and spot fleets to create the so-called Earth Guard, and station them at a base on Earth's moon.
Alright, so there is a guard on Earth's moon. We know about that. We know about the base. That ended up there was actually no one there, but he still didn't actually tell us what it is he's doing on Pluto.
Originally, we were stationed on Earth's moon, which made us Spatty a bit uneasy, because with each passing day, we grew more and more worried about the sneaky Earthlings making a surprise attack. But the Iterate kept telling us that it was impossible, since the Earthlings had no ships or weapons whatsoever. That made us feel a bit better, but when the Ilrath left, again we grew fearful, and decided to make a strategic redeployment to Mars. Later on we decided it would be prudent to relocate to Jupiter's moon, Ganymede, then later Saturn's moon, Titan, and finally here to Pluto.
Alright, so they kept moving further and further away, because those sneaky Earthlings must have been up to something. And I mean, I guess eventually we did launch an attack, but didn't really have the means to do it before Captain Zelnick came along. Let's see, so the Illrath used to be here as well.
The Illrath contingent were supposed to be the toughest ridge crest, the most rigid flipper, the backbone of the Earthguard force. But they departed the system en masse not long after the last Earthcon dreadnought vanished from this region of space. They claimed to have received a direct order from their gods of evil and darkness, who had grown dissatisfied with the Illrath's passivity and wanted them to kill or at least torture someone soon. Personally, I believe they just got bored and went off to have some fun.
Alright, so the Illrath just got bored and left.
Well, when they were pushing up into hyperspace 18 years ago, we asked them that very question, and I think they said something to the effect of, "Real soon."
It's not really much of a timetable. What is happening on the base of the moon, then?
We decided that if the Earthlings figured out we had abandoned the base on Luna, they would be more likely to try something sneaky. So, we rigged up some old service androids and ordered them to drive around on the lunar surface in bulldozers, endlessly pushing around the same piles of dirt. In addition, we connected the base's local radio transmitter to an audio Melnorme fun rum called Winky's Happy Night, hoping they would think we were still there.
Someone asked, does this come on 12 CDs? No, it is just the one. It's only the one CD. So he's the only Spathy here. They're all gone. What happened to the rest of them?
Over the past years, it became necessary to redeploy strategically some of our Earthguard forces to our homeworld in case of a sudden surprise attack by a vicious, unrelenting alien race which we Spathy call the Ultimate Evil!
The Ultimate Evil? That sounds kinda nasty. What is the Ultimate Evil, Fwiffo?
As yet, the Ultimate Evil remains largely unmanifest, and its powers and exact intentions are still a bit obscure, since it lurks just outside the range of even the most sensitive long-range detectors, which we feel gives conclusive evidence as to the Ultimate Evil's nefarious intent.
Alright, so they have not been able to detect the Ultimate Evil in any way, which is proof that it's there, and nefarious. Why is he still here?
Since it was our most powerful and unforgiving master, the Orquan, who stationed us here, we knew it would be grossly stupid to disobey them completely, but we decided it would be okay to send just one ship home. We used one of our most ancient and solemn rituals, Poon Taffy, to pick the lucky ship. Then, some months later, we decided that it wouldn't really hurt if we sent one more ship home. And then later we sent another, and then another. Well, you get the idea. Alas, as fate would have it, when the final ritual was performed, I, Fwiffo, was left here alone. For as even the most immature in questioning knows, there must always be one Spathy who picks the short top rung stick.
Alright, so they proceeded to send one ship home at a time. Nothing wrong with that. Until Fwiffo was the only one left, and he can't go home because there's no one else here to stay.
Dozens, that is to say, scores, and perhaps even hundreds of my brethren stride through the corridors of this specially modified, super-efficient, mass-destruction-oriented starship, which could lay siege to an entire planetary system, should we choose to do so, which, fortunately for you, we have decided not to do today.
Hundreds of his kind are on board that ship, huh?
I am undone! You are far too clever for a poor Spathy like me, and now I must submit to your superior alien intellect. I guess I am not revealing any truly important secrets if I tell you that each of my species' Illuder class void ships typically holds 30 Spathy crewmen, though at present my vessel, the Star Runner, is not up to full complement due to the needs of my homeworld in their resistance against the Ultimate Evil. And in fact, my vessel is somewhat understaffed right now, seeing as how I am the only Spathy on board, which is a bit threatening, as I am sure you can understand.
Okay, so, I mean, he's the only one here. He's all alone in the void. There's so many dangerous creatures out in the universe. How could he possibly feel safe here?
How true, Captain, how true. In truth, just between us, during the past 7 years, I have been quite ill at ease, and yet now I find myself enjoying your company. This witty dialogue, and in the presence of your huge, powerful, death-dealing starship, which, being my friend, you would certainly feel compelled to use in order to save me from any hostile life forms who threatened me with death.
Well, I mean, he would probably feel better if he joined us, I guess.
Happy days and jubilation! I discard all prejudice and hesitations and accept and celebrate your offer of protection and your undying commitment to my well-being. I must wax melancholy for just a moment, though, and make sure you understand that any other spotty ships we meet at large in the galaxy are not going to be quite so responsive to your friendly gestures as myself, since they bear more heavily the yoke of Urquan enslavement and are also apt to talk themselves out of a line with a totally unknown alien, which I, having been left here alone, cannot do. Welcome me aboard, Captain.
Alright, so even though we've made friends with Fwiffo, if we encounter any other Spothy, it sounds like that they are going to probably be hostile to us. Alright, so I think what we were doing last time before we got interrupted by the crashing was we were going to these planets and trying to get some minerals so we could go back and buy fuel and parts and crew and all that. Now, as you can see on the right-hand side, we do have a new ship. Fwiffo's ship has been included. But, probably should keep mining to get some money when we go back to the space station. How did I even miss that? Should I save now? All right. Can we turn on subtitles? I don't know if that's an option in this. It doesn't look like there's any option for it. Uranus. You can? I mean, I know in the PC version, but this is the 3DO version. Now, can we not do anything with this? I guess not. I guess this is not a planet we can actually send our lander down to. I know that Urquan Masters does, but of course that doesn't mean that this would. It's a gas giant? Well, I mean, I assume that our lander is capable of landing on the gas giant. Why would it not be able to? Alright, let's go up here. Okay, let's avoid Venus, and let's head to the other side here. I assume that there's no reason we cannot land on a planet made of gas. To scan that. Alright, still, man, we can't do anything with this one either. But we'll try the moon and see if it lets us land down on that. Someone asking about Star Control 3. Yeah, Star Control 3 was not thought much of. People really did not seem to like it. I never actually played Star Control 3. I've never heard anyone say anything good about it. Alright, doesn't look like there's any obstacles on here, so... Let's get us these resources. No, I don't need the scan. Are we going to play this until we beat it? I'm still not sure about it. It is a possibility. It's been a very long time since I played through Star Control 2, but yeah, maybe we might do it. What console is this for again? 3DO? Yes, this is for the 3DO Real Interactive Multiplayer. It is your console to go to for multimedia. It is a pretty long game, yes. What was so multiplayer about the 3DO? Well, I mean, you could have up to, I think, 8 players in your multiplayer games. Because even though the 3DO only had one controller port, you could connect controllers to other controllers, and I think you could have up to 8 daisy-chained. But that is not why it's called the interactive multiplayer. Multiplayer as in multimedia. Maybe you've heard of that. It's the it's the combination of all existing forms of media into a new format. How many games utilize that? Probably almost none. I kind of doubt there were many that actually used the 8 controllers. But yeah, the reason it's called multiplayer is because multimedia was the buzzword of the time, and that's the reason. Lightning. Well, maybe there's not a whole lot of it. Maybe we can avoid it. You can beat this a lot faster. Oh yeah, the way this game works, if you know exactly where to go and what you need to do to beat the game, you can actually just go, you know, immediately there and just do what you need to do real fast. But the game's not about that. It's about exploration. It's about meeting new alien races and communicating with them. Has anyone ever had 7 friends over and nothing better to play than the 3DO? Hey, if you had a 3DO interactive multiplayer, you were immediately the most popular kid on your block. Because, of course, everyone wanted to play the hot new system, and no one could because, you know, it would cost $700 when it came out. People with 3DOs didn't have friends? No, people with 3DOs, you know, they were the rich kids. You know, they were the people who people pretended to be friends with because they were rich and had all the video games. All right, let's head to Earth. I can't remember if we actually did do anything on Mars. I'll just take a look at it. Yeah, $700 ambush bug. I mean, we're not talking about $700 today. I mean, a console would still be far too expensive at $700 today in 2014. But when we're talking about, like, 1993, maybe it came out? Something like that? It's just that they had a really... They didn't have a great idea of who it was they were marketing this thing to. Oh, wait, are we on... Okay, we're on Mercury, yeah. So it's real hot. And there are hazards, but... It's not overwhelming like Venus was, at least. I don't want to know what the PS3, PS4, 360, and Xbone cost in Latin America. Yeah, I can imagine. I can imagine the inflated prices. I think a couple of my crew got killed right there. Alright, let's head out. Let's head back to the Soul Station. They fell in the lava. There's still a red resource dot there? Well, we probably should just head back at this point. Don't risk any more crew members falling in lava. So yeah, I mean, if you're wondering about the price of the 3DO, it was because, they were advertising it as, you know, a top of the line technology, a set-top box that, you know, you could do all kinds of different kinds of software on. Video game, it was pushed heavily as a video game, but that wasn't the only thing. The problem was that people weren't really receptive to what it was they were trying to sell, and I mean, the closest thing to that model was the video game console model, which people were expecting far cheaper prices than what 3DO was doing. It was cheaper than a CDI?
Hello,
probably.
Captain.
Let's offload some stuff. Yep, look at my RUs going up. My RUs were resource
my
units.
Load this time, Captain.
Was it really top-of-the-line hardware? Oh, yeah, at the time it came out, certainly, I mean, there weren't any consoles that were more powerful. I mean, possibly Neo Geo, but that was not really the same thing at all, and they did different things, really.
Certainly, Captain. What do you need to know?
Know anything about FWIFO here? It doesn't look like it.
Fine. Is there anything else you need?
Where are the rave lights?
Captain.
Well, I mean, the rave lights were because the station was falling apart and had no power. But, we fixed those. Alright, let's get some crew in here. Build up this crew. Alright, 50 is my max. The Earth ship, I think, is at its max. Yep. And Fwifo's ship, let's get 29 humans on board with Captain Fwifo. I'm sure they'll get along just fine. And yes, the Starbase music is really good. Alright, I'm gonna need some fuel. Oh, nope. I guess that's the max fuel I can get. Alright, let's see. What can I... I don't... I do have enough for another fuel tank. I guess I might as well get that. And fill up with fuel. I know I do need to turn thrusters, but I just don't have enough for it. Are there any more enemies in our solar system? I don't think there are. I think we've gone through everything at this point. So, I mean, that means it's time for the first time to exit the solar system, I guess. The CDI had arguably the worst controller ever. The one I got with mine actually does have a fair controller. We'll talk more about that when we do things with the CDI. Alright, we're in hyperspace! Time to go to Alpha Centauri, which is the closest system. Alright, what do we got here? Flowers of Robert Mapplethorpe. Well, truly, this is a very artistic stream, so maybe we could. This isn't running on an emulator? No, this is an actual 3DO. Only the best for Star Control 2. All right, what do we have here? We only seem to have the one planet. No. That's not what I wanted to do. Does going in hyperspace consume resources? I mean, traveling in it does use fuel. I don't know if it uses any more fuel than just normal impulse engines. All right. Scan the Alanthanide world. So not every planet, of course, will have a name. Because there's a lot. Oh yeah, actually does say Sirius up there. But that's the system, isn't it? Alright. Let's put the lander down. Let's see if there's anything dangerous down here. Oh yeah! Yep! Bro, it's real dangerous! That was really dangerous! I think we shouldn't go down there. And we lost so many good people in our journey to Sirius. Don't know if there's anything else in this system to look at. Said right there, 1,110 degrees. I figured they could take it. Alright, I guess let's go head back into hyperspace. Alright, let's go to the upper left. We can see that there's something there. So yeah, at this point it's pretty open-ended. We're doing a lot of exploration, just trying to figure out where it is we want to go. And if there's anything there. Alright, this is a much bigger system. Maybe we'll find something good here. What do we need to free the Earth? Well, it's trapped by a slave shield, so we need to be able to figure out how to drop the Urquan slave shield, which will end up, you know, means that we have to take on the Urquan. And they're just so powerful, no one can do that. Gas giant, nothing we can do. The ultimate objective is lowering the shield. Part of it, yeah, but it's also to defeat the Urquan and end their star empire of slavery. So those objectives are really one and the same. There is sort of another objective, saving the universe from something else that maybe we'll find out about later on. Iodine world. But right now, what we're concerned with is the Urquan, those green tentacle-y things, and them wanting to just enslave everyone. Alright, there's some stuff down here, but I think we can handle it. Losing good people in our quest for resources, but we need these resources. go die for resources, my crew? Well, yeah, I mean, hard decisions have to be made when it comes to freeing the universe from the tentacly slimy grasp of the Urquan. And have a good night, Charm. Area world. Alright, there's a bunch of biologicals down here. Ah! No, we don't want anything of that! I don't want anything of that! No, we're getting out of here! No, goodbye! Alright, so remember, biologicals are disgusting. Alright, I'll save. It's a super dense world. There is a one life form here. It is moving around. Well, I mean, maybe we can handle one. We'll see what it is. We do have guns on this. It's a little pew-pew gun. Not much, but maybe we can do something. There it is. Alright. It's the only life form on this planet. I guess let's go kill it. Oh, it turned into something. No, we did not romance it. We, I don't know what we picked up. I still don't know. I guess it's some kind of resource. We picked up its corpse. Maybe we can offload that as well. Another super dense world. Oh no, we captured the living creature? Alright. And then we'll perform the experiments on the alien life form that we captured. The system sucks. Yeah, not a whole lot going on in this system. I believe the only location we've been given so far is when we talked to Fwifo. It was mentioned what the coordinates of his system are. I think we could enter that information in and head there. If I remember this game right. We could do that, but remember... Oh, it's an Azure world. How pretty. But remember, yeah, it's, Fwifo's people, the Spothy, they're still under the enslavement... Oh, so many biologicals. Let's pick up the non-biological stuff. They're still working for the Urquan. Ah. Ah. Okay, bad idea. Bad idea. Let's leave this place. Alright, I guess this is a gas giant. Yeah. Space exploration, yeah, I would say it is mostly running away. I would say that's a pretty good description of it. head back to Seoul. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll, let's just explore this, see what resources we can get, and then we're gonna head back to Seoul. What am I planning to upgrade next? Well, like people have said, it would be good to be able to increase speed in turning. Yeah, I guess probably another gas giant. How do the humans feel about Fwifo? I don't know if we can get the humans' opinions on him. Sometimes the Starbase commander might mention something about a new ally. But I don't think he's mentioned anything about Fwifo. Fwifo is also an example of optional things that you can find in this game. Like, I don't think there's a reason you have to go to Pluto and find him. It's just something like, you know, you're exploring all the planets in the solar system, or all of the planets in one dwarf planet now. And if you do that, you'll come across Fwifo, but you don't have to, I'm pretty sure. Oh, someone asking, can Fwifo die? Yep, he sure can. It's a purple world. Alright, looks like a world with no monsters on it. And it doesn't look like there are any hazards, so that's good. Oh, there are some hazards, but very sparse. Please save before I go into hyperspace, since that's where encounters happen. Sure, I can do that. In fact, whoops, no. I can save it now, since I guess we're going to leave this system. I think that's the last thing to look at in here. All right, let's head back to Seoul, fuel up, and get more crew members, and then we'll try to figure out what it is we want to do. Try auto-navigate. You can do it from the space map. All right, let's, here's the star map. Oh, okay, now, all right, this is something we should take a look at. There are spheres that have now appeared on the star map. We can see a sphere that says Spothy and a sphere that says Ilroth. What that refers to is the sphere of influence of these races, these species. If we were to go to the circle that says Spothy, we would encounter Spothy. The Ilroth, as you can see, is really close to Earth. So, if we went in there, we would start encountering the Ilroth, and they're not happy people. We already encountered one of them at the beginning. But, for right now, let's go to Seoul. Okay. I think... yeah, there we go. Now we're automatically going. This is autopilot I'm on. Oh wait, was that not Seoul? Did I see that wrong? Yeah, I don't think this is Seoul. I think I passed it. Anyway, I didn't want to say anything because the music is pretty good. All right. So hard to see. I mean, that looks like a green stun. I don't think that's going to be it. Okay, yeah, okay, I see this. I see it now, yeah. There is Saul. We went just way past it. But that's okay, because we got to listen to the music. Oh no! We're encountering someone. Who could this be?
We come in peace.
Well, they say they come in peace, so I guess that's a good thing.
We come in peace.
Let us reach out our appendage in friendship.
Mission description follows. Traverse space recording data. Seek materials for replication. Replicate to expand scope of mission. Contact life forms in peaceful manner. After 10 replications, return to point of origin. End of mission description. Priority override. New behavior dictated. Must brave target into component materials.
Oh, well, that doesn't sound good. So we have a fight on our hands. Well, we could try Fwiffo, but let's see where we could go with Spiff. Now, Spiff, I think, probably is longer range. So let's see how this goes. But, oh, he's so fast! Yeah, that did not work out. All right, let's see what Fwiffo's got. I think I hit this. Yeah, I hit the escape. Yeah. Didn't want to do that. All right, I guess let's go with the flagship. This is not going to be pretty. I can't believe we won. So we can see the name of the ship. It's a Slylandro. We'll find out more about them as we go on. All right, well, I was thinking that it's probably a good time for a break, and I didn't really want to lose my Earth ship because our flagship is so bad right now, so we'll probably just reload. We'll probably just do that. But that, I think that's going to be enough for Star Control 2 for right now. Next time round, we'll reload, and then we'll just head back to Earth. And, you know, maybe I'll get a bit better at combat, so I won't lose so quickly. For right now, though, I think it's time to go to intermission. And when we come back, I think we're going to head back to our random 3DO grab bag, in which I'm going to stick something in the 3DO, and we'll see what it is. So, be back in about 10 minutes. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the stream, and welcome back to some 3DO fun times. So I popped something in the stream into the 3DO, which then goes into the stream, that I don't think was ever actually released in America or in English. So that's fun. Hopefully it's understandable without it, without any English. Oh, that's enough English right there. I can see I need to push the P button. The start button on the 3DO, by the way, is called P, which I guess means play. I guess that's what that's for. Oh, hold on. I'm sorry. Missing the music. So, I mean, that we can see that something bad happened and it's in the newspaper. A while back. Now, this is happening right now. That's happening. East Asia? Oh no. And Detroit? What's happening there? And then somewhere,
a typewriter.
So, if you're wondering what this is, it's a very early survival horror game. How Danny Elfman of the game. Jack Slade is asking, pre-Resident Evil? Oh, pre. Very much pre. Extremely pre. Probably not pre-Alone in the Dark, though. This is probably post-Alone in the Dark. Have I played through this one? No, I've only checked it to see that it was working. I don't know much about it at all. But, I mean, here's our character. I don't know if we're Dr. Hauzer or if we're looking for the doctor. I guess let's start. Enter this house of madness. A house of hell, maybe? Possibly. I'll just let that sink in as you read the intro text and get an idea of what's happening here. Just to get a clear idea of what we're doing here in the world of Dr. Hauzer. It's pretty menacing music that's playing right now, though, so we should probably be spooked out right now. know, man. Did the knocker come off the door? This house isn't just falling into disrepair. Here we are. Oh, yeah. Take a look at these real-time polygons. Alright, gameplay has started. That could have fallen right on us. We'd better be careful in this house. Oh, yeah, this feels really good. Very responsive controls. Okay, I can look with the A button. I can do a little jump with the C button. B button does not seem to do anything. Oh, I can change camera angles. Okay, I can go into first-person mode, and oh man. Let's not do that ever again. I can also go from... Oh, look at that. That is beautiful. Alright, let's go through the door. Okay, I kind of have to hold on to the A button to make him open the door. Okay. No one here to greet us in this house. There's a clock. Oh, there's a painting and a clock. Let's take a look at those. Yeah, the 3DO really can't do very many polygons on screen at once. It's not good at that. I guess he's observing the portrait, but I don't know what he's saying. Oh, that's where you hide a key in the creepy house. You hide it in the grandfather clock. Huh? Our character does not seem to know what happened right there. Was something behind us? I don't even know what that was supposed to represent. Okay, it looks like that the clock's moving now. It's working. Something over here? There's another painting over here. Was the house growing? I could not tell what it was I was supposed to be getting from that. Oh, we're just taking the most casual stroll of our lives through this haunted house. Alright, here's a door. Is it locked? I guess so. I wonder if... Can I use... My... I guess that... Am I saving? I think I just saved. And what's this one do? Okay, those are the... That's basic operation. That's how we control the game. Alright, I'm gonna guess that if I could have used the key, he would have automatically have used it because I don't... Oh, and upstairs. I don't see... I don't see any button to open up the inventory or anything, so I'm gonna have to just assume that. And can I not go up the stairs? I'm gonna jump up these stairs. I cannot jump up the stairs. Oh, we're walking through molasses in this house. Single door or double doors? Well, the double doors look so inviting. Are they locked? I guess these double doors are locked. What about you, single door? Pretty sure GameFAQs would have one. Eh, who knows? Maybe. Maybe they have this game figured out. Alright, this one was open. Oh, and it just takes you right back to the title screen, does it? Well, it's a good thing we saved. All right, so that's the kind of game this is. Just letting you know off the bat that this is what's in store for you. But that gives us a problem because I can't open any of the doors. I can't go up the stairs. That's the only door I can open, and there is just instant death right behind it. Anything on this table? What about you, Couch? Nothing? I would like to sit on the couch, but I don't know if I can. Alright, so Jonathan Nemo posting an FAQ. That is something that I might have to give a read if we're going to play Dr. Hauzer to any extent. I might assume that we have to use the key here, but... but I don't know how to use it. There must be a way of going up the stairs. Maybe. I'm gonna try the stairs again and see if I push combinations of things if I go up them. Because there doesn't seem to be a reason why I can't go up these stairs. Eh. Jump up those stairs? Nah. No, can't do it. And look at this creepy first-person view of the stairs. The creepiest of views. Let's get up right close to those portraits and see in first-person mode what they look like. Oh yes, you like this, don't you? This is not causing any motion sickness at all, is it? Can you play this on the Oculus? I can only hope that there is a PC port so we can get that included. Is the death scene different in first person? I guess there's only one way to find out. Oh, let's check the windows. Oh, something happened? Got a little cutscene of our guy looking through this window, but I guess nothing happened. Why were old horror games like this, Alone in the Dark and Resident Evil, brightly colored? Oh, it was just the look at the time. Video games were bright and colorful. And then later on, you know, when graphics got better, they realized that if you want your games to look better and more real, then you have to make them, you know, have to take the colors out and make everything brown. This movement is incredible. Alright, let's take a look at the death scene and see if it's any different in first person. Then we'll probably move on to something else. I'll take a look at the fact to see if I can figure out what we need to do at some point, and maybe we'll give it another try. Nope, that is exactly the same. Alright, Dr. Hauzer in a very early survival horror game, and I would not say we're probably going to play all the way through it. I would like to see more of it just to see what's in store, what's in here. But can't work out where to go from here, so I'll look at the FAQ and see if I can figure something out at some other time. For right now, however, here's something that's a little unusual for the 3DO. It's a JRPG called Lucienne's Quest. This was also released, I think, for the Saturn. But it's unusual for the 3DO in that it's a JRPG, and that's not really a genre that had much representation on this platform. right, so you got what's going on. There was an angry man in armor who apparently woke up a dragon. I think it's what was happening. It's kind of hard to tell. So one thing to know about, you know, this era is, you know, with any era of video games, developers like to try to use the, you know, the most advanced technology of the time, even if maybe it's not a great idea. So an example of this is that all of the environments in this game are polygonal, even though the 3DO does not seem to be up to the task. It could have just been in 2D and it would have been fine. Yep, there she is. She's all happy. She's happy anime girl. Oh man, I wonder if that's the love interest with a dark past. Yep, he turns into a wolf. He is definitely the love interest. And we got the cute mascot character too. All your JRPG cliches are here. I'm not sure which cliche that is, but I'm looking forward to meeting that individual. And Yoshimitsu? What do you, I had no idea that he was in this game. Well, as you saw from that dramatic camera spin, we are entering a truly epic quest right here. We're entering into the wonderful magical world. Let's go. All right, Lucienne's Quest, made in 1995 by Microcabin. Let's press the P button and get moving with this epic Japanese adventure where we play roles. The role that we are playing as is Lucienne. Oh, okay, let's start a new game. Let's get going. I love the sweeping camera angles. You could tell at the time they made it, like, they felt this was so impressive. Anyway, this is the famous Tower of Pinakothek, home of the great sorcerer Kokindo. Okay, this is probably the werewolf guy, because he's cursed. The whole game looks a little drunk. Yeah, it does. He does look a little bit tipsy. What? Oh no! We're very alarmed by this person entering. These text boxes have personality. Alright, here's Lucienne. Very alarmed at this person entering the tower. Okay, Ago, or Ego, I'm not sure how it's pronounced. Nope, he's gone. He's traveled so far to meet the wizard. How can it happen like this? Lucienne's young and inexperienced. What does she know about caring for the tower? That's how that saying goes. Oh, that was the joke, I see. a visitor, you say? Pretty great dialogue. I mean, yeah, it's a simple RPG. It's not gonna have, you know, loads of dialogue and text, and that's probably for the best. Just simple sentences and dialogue. Ago is so distraught. Who will help him with his curse? Okay. They were cursed by the Junin. Junin? Oh, it's not just him, but it's everyone from his village. Everyone's turning into wolfmen. Well, I mean, we could wait for him to come back. I mean, I don't think all hope is gone. They have a specific thing for the text box being a thought balloon. It's little details like that. See, she has powers. She can consult the crystal ball. Well, I mean, now you know where you have to go, right? So it wasn't for nothing. Oh, she's just making it up. I mean, that's kind of mean, Lucienne, to do that. When exactly is the gameplay? Hey, this is an RPG. The gameplay gets here when it's good and ready. But she's... I don't know what the parentheses would be representing. And they have dynamic fonts. You can increase the size of them for emphasis. Alright, looks like we have a party, and I guess that we're going. Lucienne, though, is unaware of the dangers. I guess she's gonna find out about them. Alright, we're moving around. We're looking at stuff. Right, so like I was saying, they had this, you know, they had the environments as, made out of polygons. And yeah, as you're noticing, the frame rate. They could have just done it in 2D and it would have been fine, but, you know, polygons are new and interesting, so you're making your games with polygons, even though the system can't seem to do this very well. And yeah, the music loop is kind of going. Oh, crab man! All right, so I mean, we have to find our own magic. We can't just rely on Kokindo's magic forever. This is a coming-of-age story for Lucienne. Alright, got some stamina medicine. So, I mean, from what they said, we're just looking for equipment and gear to take with us on the quest. You thought the 3DO could not actually do 3D? I mean, it can do polygons. There are some polygonal games on it. It's just that it couldn't do it very well, for the most part. I'm just trying to think about if there were any games that actually had smooth-running polygons on the 3DO, and I don't remember. Alone in the Dark? Maybe. I'm not sure. I don't remember how smoothly Alone in the Dark ran. And can I not get past this? Nah. Something in there. Can't seem to interact with these boxes, though. Now, those are our stats. Oh, great. That's what I need. Oh, okay. Wasn't quite close enough. I need to not press the button immediately because I'm missing some windows. Alright, let's see if we can equip anything here. Yes, a single leather boot. You'd think that there would be just a pair instead of just the one, but I don't know. Nope, we don't have any items to install over those other ones. What does he have? I think I saved. I'm not sure if I did. Alright, let's head on outside. I mean, we spent enough time in here. Let's go out. Go on our quest. See if we can help Ago with his curse. Even though we're so inexperienced, and we're just like a sorcerer's apprentice, and we really have not done anything on our own. And it is an RPG, so hey, random battles. Here we go. Alright, so I did a little thing with this before, just trying to figure out how this worked. So the way this works is, we have this character and we can move him around like this. We want to get him aligned up with the monster, I think. And then attack. Alright, now, Lucienne is not as physically tough as Ago, so I'm just going to put her behind him and maybe use some magic. Maybe, I don't know, fireballs? Yeah, that sounds alright. Gonna use our weakest powers. I burnt that wolf to death. Yeah, you saw me do it. I'm not sorry for it. What's the point of having to line up your attacks? I don't remember. All I can remember is that the trees and bushes can block things. So, I mean, they can block enemy attacks, but they can also block your attacks. So part of the combat system is taking advantage of any obstacles on the field as well. All right, it looks like now I can save. Alright, let's walk around and see what we can find. Encounter rate seems a little high. Alright, so say for instance, Ago, I mean, I think he has to get a good lineup with the enemies, so because he's using a physical attack. Lucienne, I think, I mean, I could put her behind here, and then maybe I can, maybe I can use my healing magic on Ago. And that was a lot, actually. Oh, so there you go. Lucienne is defended by the trees. But I can't get at them either, I think, because of those trees. I'm just going to defend, because I don't think I can get them. Now, Lucienne, I'm not sure if her magic needs to have a straight line, so let's try fireballs and see if that works. Yeah, it does. That wolf is biting that tree! Let's see, can I get around that? Like, put him there and try attacking from there? Oh, nope. It kinda worked, but there was another bush in the way. I'm just gonna leave her there. Look, wolf, I mean, you're gonna have to move out. Okay, there he goes. The wolf ran away, because we killed its mate. So it's just going to run away now alone and injured, and probably will die in great amount of pain. Is what just happened right now, so I want you to understand that. Alright, more wolves. Different colored wolves. I think that has to do... that has to do with the time of day. Ago taking a lot of punishment, but I didn't want to attack him because the tree's in the way. All right, I'm gonna have to use a Lucienne's magic, heal him up. All right, now attack the center one. No, not that one. That wolf is very agile. Just dodged right out of the way, and now Ago's dead. All right, looks like Lucienne is going to have to finish this off herself with fireballs, and let's go with power number two. Maybe we should see if we can heal up Ago. Okay, it looks like that he is not dead. He is down to one hit point. Alright, let's continue on and see what we can... Okay, it's night completely. Now, we do know that there is this day-night cycle going on. And at night, Ago transforms into a wolf! Look, he's a wolf man right now! And a lot of trees here. I guess we'll attack the tree. Do wolves still attack the wolf man? I do not know, but... I mean, who knows if there are even wolves out at night? I could not say. And what does that say? Okay, we can go to north to the colony or east to Baba Chop. Well, Baba Chop is where we're supposed to be going. So, let's see if we can find it. Did this come out on anything other than the 3DO? Well, I guess we are fighting wolves. I believe it did come out on the Saturn. Let me just defend, since there are these bushes in the way. That's a little sensitive on that, on moving the character around. I'm also use a little bit of healing here. The Saturn version is worse. I'm having trouble, not to downplay the game, I'm having a little trouble wondering how it would, like, what that would be like. Oh, critical hit is what that looked like. Looks like Lucienne went up a level. People talking about the Saturn, but it could do this. It could run a game like this smoothly. There were certainly more demanding games that came out on the Saturn. Now, what am I fighting here? Not sure. I'm fighting a dead creepy. I guess that's what we're doing. Maybe let's try doing a physical attack with Lucy and see how that goes. Alright, not bad. Oh, I think we might have found a town. Yep, we're at Baba Chop. What menacing looking masks. Thanks for letting me know. This is pretty great music, yes. There's a cave here. Yeah, we did encounter one of them. It was kind of tough, but nothing we couldn't handle. Aha! Uh-huh. So the ogre and the mole bear are natural enemies. I don't know if he can help us. I don't know if anyone can help us. But we can buy weapons. Alright, looks like Lucienne can take the club. I guess we'll do that. Alright, so at least we have a weapon now. Thank you. You're trying to understand what the whole plot's about? Well, Ago and his people have been cursed by the Junin, the Beastmen, to turn into Wolfmen when it's night. And he wants the wizard's help, but the wizard was not in his tower. He encountered the apprentice, Lucienne, who just was bored and made up a story about where he had to go next, but was just making it up. Because she's bored. So he thinks that we're going to where we need to go, but, I mean, Lucienne knows that we're not. And that she just wants to get out of the tower from time to time. Oh, there's a war on. Restricting travel, this war against the ogres. We're on top of this thing. I wonder if there's anything here we need. Yeah, we already got here. This is some amazing music, by the way. Yes, you are right about that. Oh, I think this is new. What's going on? The rebellious son, refusing to follow this tradition that he just sees as being foolishness. Alright, so there was a lot of dialogue right there about what they want to do, but I think we're probably just going to save and just try to go on to something else. Oh, but no, we can't because there's another cutscene. Here's Mibinaga, I guess. He does not want to fight the ogres! Yeah, and someone mentioned before, yes, this is pretty amazing dialogue. Mibinaga does not want to go with them. Oh, Lucienne, so scandalous! Ha ha! keep in mind, I'm pretty sure this character is not human. I'm pretty sure this character is the rabbit character we saw from the intro. So, that's something to just keep in mind. Yeah, you can see his picture there. I'm pretty sure that's what it is. So maybe I'm just going... Maybe I'll just leave and save, and then we'll go on to something else. All right. You know, it's pretty late. So maybe it's an appropriate time for something a little bit after hours. It's Snow Job versus starring Tracy Scoggins. Yeah, I don't know who either. I have not heard the name, but it's starring her. It's a, I guess, IXL. It's a barely legible production. Now, I'm pretty sure this is not porn. I guess I don't know that for sure. So we'll find out together.
Raul.
Snowman, I was just reading your New York newspaper. I'm not pleased. Now I trust you'll do whatever is necessary to keep Ms. Laura Calabrese in check. This interference is the last thing that we need, especially right now.
I'll take care of it.
The press interfering with these drug trades.
Ice pick.
Yeah, now. You say the words, no man.
Oh no, ice pick is... and contracted to assassinate this reporter.
Jock, it's Wires. Get your ass in the saddle and get back your good buddy. Your friend Lara's in deep trouble.
What do you mean?
Just do it, Jock. Make it fast. I'll explain everything when you get here.
All right. Hey, Felix. We're gonna have to find someone to feed you for a while. I'm off to New York. I'm not too happy about it either. Oh, gotta get up, gotta get up. Oh, yeah.
Felix is gonna have to take care of himself. Oh goodness. Things are heating up on the 3DO. With chests getting licked and all everything. So much chest licking. I remember those good times, getting my chest licked.
You want me to go first?
Ooh, you got to go first last time.
Right, just nice and easy.
Okay.
Right. Now.
Oh no, our partner! He didn't even get to get his chest licked. All right, so we have a partner who died and we're tortured by it, and I guess we also knew the woman that we're going to protect. And, that's interesting. It's kind of... kind of like a really early version of Google Maps. Look out. I'm looking out. Let's see what we... Oh, maybe we can go in here. All right, we're going into Wires' loft. Wires is obviously our hacker friend. Oh, we can't look at Wires?
The sofa. A little lumpy, but serviceable.
Well, yeah, these environments are actually pretty high res for the time and the system. So I guess we can't talk to Wires. He doesn't mind us just walking around his place,
stereo.
Though. What?
Stereo. Bet it has more watts than a power station.
No, I wouldn't think so. That does not look like it would.
Stereo.
Nope.
Bet it has more watts than a power station.
No, nope, let's go back. Stop looking at that.
Refrigerator, probably stocked with cola and stale pizza.
Yeah, he's a nerd. He's on the computer all the time. I bet it's just full of moldy food. Like, man, so much flat Mountain Dew. Probably. How did I get a hold of this game? Well, I mean, the way I got a hold of most of my 3DO games, if you know what I'm saying.
VCR, looks like this one works.
Unfortunately, I guess we don't have anything to put in it.
VCR, looks like this one works.
Yes, the sex trade. That is how I got my 3DO games. It's a rough way of getting them. You better appreciate what I do for this stream.
Teletap, one of my old standbys for tapping telephones. Only this one is designed to monitor circuits used for data transmission. You've got the laptop computer and two connectors. You'll need a new headset, though, so you can hear.
All right, I guess so it's for tapping phone calls. I guess we'll be doing some of that later on.
The photo must be Grandpa Harris.
Super Tracker. My own modification. Just plant under a car bumper, it'll tell you where the car goes. You'll hear the receiving unit beep when the car stops at a new location. Until it gets out of range.
Oh, you mean all you have
to... I think it needs a mini battery, though.
All you have to do is put this small, inconspicuous device on a car, and it will tell you where it goes. Look out! And no one will notice that it's there.
Computer printer, all stocked with paper.
Now, why would a true nerd need a printer? That's something for straights. The normies.
Ah,
they print stuff out.
Phone. I'll definitely need that.
That's good. We will definitely need to make use of this phone.
Ah, here's the phone. I'll definitely need that.
What you looking at, Wires? What are you looking at there? I'm not sure if I can turn it up. It's as high as it can go. Like, I have everything turned up. So I guess it's just a quiet game. Huh. See, now that's pretty loud. All right, so this is the 90s, so maybe... I think I'm gonna bail out. I remember my computer. It used to make noises like that when there was an error. Oh no, we don't have... We need to get more RAM so we can run HackNet. Pillows, you're correct. I have not talked about getting my chest licked in a while. And I know that is something that's of most importance. Oh, hey, the extra chain gun is under the stairs. Just watch out for the Cyber Gator. Oh, it's talking about a computer game. Too bad it's not talking about this game. All right, Wires, I'm looking right behind you. Can you talk to me? No? We're not doing that? It's not something you're into, Wires? You don't want to talk to anyone unless it's over Skype? I'm not sure what we're supposed to do. I really have not gotten much direction. I guess let's just go outside. All right, can I do anything out here?
Why are the cars covered? Construction in the neighborhood?
I don't know.
What? Acid rain?
I don't know. Why would the cars be covered? Maybe there's something going on in this neighborhood. Maybe they're wondering about acid rain. Why are these cars covered right here? I don't know. My car was covered when I remember getting my chest licked and my partner got shot. I'm not sure why that happened either. I wonder where that woman is I'm supposed to lay out for. She's somewhere around here. It's my job to get to her so she doesn't get killed by Ice Pick. I don't know if Wires can help me with that. I mean, I'm here at Wires' house and I guess I'm supposed to get help from him in order to find where she is so she doesn't get killed. Can Wires help me with that? I mean, he's just sitting here at his computer playing Dota. And he does this all day, every day. I tell him, you gotta get off Dota and help me with the job. And he's like, no, I have to push back these creeps. I'm watching The International right now on Twitch. I can't help you with the girl. I promise him a chest licking if he helps me with that, but no, he's not doing anything. Can I make it say something besides look? Let's see. Okay, I do have an inventory. I have Jock's file.
Lara Calabresi, assistant DA. Honest, smart, and tough. Also a pushover for fresh-cut flowers and stray cats.
Also,
the disgraced ex-cop was getting a little worn around the edges.
Also a chest licker. And, so she's not a reporter, she's the assistant DA, and she's getting too close to the source of crime.
The DeLauro case, 2 years ago. What the hell happened that night? All I remember is a routine surveillance detail, me and my partner Wires. Next thing I know, I'm knocked on the head and Wires is on permanent disability.
Oh, so Wires did not die. Wires was the partner cop who got shot, and now that's why he's in the wheelchair here. All right, let's see if I can change... Oh, there we go. Look, talk, take, you... Okay, let's talk. Wires, I'm about to put my lips on your head, and I hope you're responsive.
Good to see you, Jock. I'll bet you have some questions.
Is this even the same room, Wires? I came in... There's sunlight. There was sunlight pouring in the room... When I came in, I was looking around, but it seems like it's at night right now. Why is Lara in trouble?
Okay, hotshot. You called. I came. So tell me what's going on.
I'll show you.
I've been poking around the internet, and I tell you, man, sometimes you just come across the damnedest things.
The internet?
I ran across this scrambled message, which I decrypted partly. Check it out.
Man, this guy's on the internet. All right, so Snowman wants a surprise for her birthday, as we can see. You got that on the internet?
You got that on the internet? People communicate on the internet. Business, politics, sex.
What?
Sometimes I eavesdrop. The other day I tapped into some news group. I don't know, it was something about saving the environment off of Long Island Sound. Anyway, there were some encrypted messages, just like the one I showed you about Lara. What it's worth, here's the internet address.
Tell me more about these news groups you're talking about. I mean, this is not a news group. This is just a website. This is just like a really early 90s website we're looking here. They want to save Long Island Sound. I'm not seeing anything newsgroupish about this, Wires. What is this, Snowman?
So what is this Snowman? The Snowman. Snowman is a badass man. He's bad news. He's a big-time coke dealer. The cat is like a shadow. Nobody knows who he is. The only thing that we know is that if Lara is on his shit list, she is in serious trouble.
All right, let's get down to brass tacks. I have nowhere to stay in New York, Wires. Can I stay in your place? We're old partners, you know.
I'm gonna need a bed for a few days so I can get a handle on this.
Hey, you can rack on my spare bunk, unless you prefer the Y, huh? Feel free to use any of my gear, you know? Some of that stuff is rusty, though, so there is a decent electronics shop over on 14th Street.
Someone asked, what is my favorite news groups? Alexis Royce. I lurked around Rec Sport Pro Wrestling quite often. Never posted much. Let's end the conversation here. All right, you know, it's been over 3 hours, so I think this is probably a good time to end the stream. Did I ever use Net? Yeah, I used Usenet for a while, really. Mostly for the wrestling news group, so I could, you know, see conversations between what people thought about what was happening in mid-90s in wrestling, and what, Hulk Hogan turned heel? He's in the NWO? Oh man, what does the internet think about that? Can I save? Why is that the pause screen? Why is it like a blotch of green stuff? I've not seen anything in the game so far which would indicate that's why that would be the pause screen. Now here we go, save the game. And now it's red. Alright. I don't know, maybe we'll return back to Snowjob at some point. This seems like it is much more of a game than I thought it was gonna be. I knew that it was a steamy FMV thriller. I knew that part about it, but I didn't know about this whole adventure aspect of it, so I don't know. Maybe there's more to it than I thought, maybe it could be worth taking more of a look at. But for right now, I think that is enough for the stream, and so what did we do tonight? We went through some Dead.Kings, played some checkers, we got a little bit further in Star Control 2 and met Captain Fwiffo, and then we looked at some Dr. Hauzer, some Lucien's Quest, and some Snowjob. So I hope everyone had fun, and I hope everyone is going to have a good week, and we'll be back next time, probably, I don't know, probably we'll take... Oh, don't worry about falling asleep, pillows. That's all right. I know it's late. We'll probably do a little bit more Star Control 2, and we'll figure out what comes next, I think. If we return to any of these, or if there are any other new stuff to take a look at. I hope to get the next mode video out this week. I really should get that done. But that one should be done this week, I think. There's a few X-Bligs. And I haven't done a video on yet, so maybe I could do that. And found a game I'm probably going to do a demo friend on called Insanity's Blade. I think it's what it was called. It's on Desura. So that's probably what's coming up this week anyway. So anyway, everyone, have a good week. Have a good night. And yeah, we'll come back next week. Do some more of this. We'll have to see. You know, we'll just decide what it is we end up doing. So, like I said, have a good week. That's it for the stream. And I guess we'll just end with our little viewing of our mouth on the back of Wires' head as we dream of being forever licked. See you next time.